Welcome to the Myeloma University module entitled CAR T Therapy in Multiple Myeloma. My name is Donna Catamero, and I'm a nurse practitioner with the Mount Sinai Health System in New York City. In this short discussion, we will discuss the patient journey and management of CAR T therapy in multiple myeloma. CAR T therapies are a novel form of immunotherapy where the patient's own T cells are engineered with a chimeric antigen receptor, or CAR, to target a specific protein on the myeloma cell, causing greater cell kill. CAR T therapy is associated with unique toxicities, most notably cytokine release syndrome, or CRS, and neurotoxicity. We will do a deeper dive on these toxicities, but first, let's review the patient journey. Let's begin. As may become evident in this discussion, a patient caregiver is an important part of the CAR T treatment journey. Once a patient is deemed eligible for CAR T therapy, they are consented and undergo apheresis, where the patient's T cells are harvested and then shipped for manufacturing. The T cells will be genetically engineered with the CAR that targets a receptor on the myeloma cell. While the cells are being manufactured, a patient may receive bridging chemotherapy to control their disease until the CAR T cells are ready for infusion. Several days prior to the CAR T cell infusion, patient will receive lymphodepletion chemotherapy. This typically consists of fludarabine and cyclophosphamide. The chemotherapy decreases the patient's own T cells to make room for the CAR T cells that will be infused. When the CAR T cells are ready to be infused, patients will be pre-medicated with acetaminophen and an antihistamine. Patients will then receive the CAR T infusion as an IV infusion via a central line. Post-infusion, we will closely monitor the patient for 7 to 14 days, and this will typically take place in an inpatient setting. So what is CAR T? CARs are receptor proteins that give the patient's T cells a new ability to target a specific protein on the myeloma cell. The patient's own T cells have learned to target and kill the myeloma cell, or they can recruit other parts of the patient's own immune system to help. Targets currently approved and being investigated are BCMA, or B-cell maturation antigen, which is an ideal target as it's universally expressed on myeloma cells and does play a role in proliferation and cell survival, as well as CD38, which is a commonly expressed antigen on myeloma cells. The most common adverse events from CAR T are infections, prolonged cytopenias, CRS, and neurotoxicity. CRS occurs as a result of T cell activation, causing a large release of cytokines. CRS presents as a cluster of symptoms that can potentially be life-threatening and can occur any time between the first day up until 30 days post-infusion. Typically, CRS will start off as a fever, fatigue, or headaches. More severe symptoms include hypotension, dyspnea, respiratory distress, clotting disorders, and other organ toxicities. It is very important that if a patient does present with a fever, that we rule out infection before we rule in CRS. For mild cases of CRS, symptoms can be managed with supportive care. For high grades of CRS, we will typically manage patients with tocilizumab and corticosteroids. It is required that institutions have 2 doses of tocilizumab available for each patient prior to the infusion of the CAR T cells. Neurotoxicity can occur either in conjunction with CRS or as an isolated event. To manage neurotoxicity, we typically treat prophylactically with anti-seizure medications at the time of lymphodepletion chemotherapy. We also provide supportive care with corticosteroids. Onset of neurotoxicity varies between 1 to 30 days post-infusion. The exact mechanism of action for neurotoxicity is unknown, but can manifest as a headache, tremors, difficulty swallowing, decreased attention, confusion, or lethargy. CAR T cells can kill healthy B cells, and this can lead to B cell aplasia, chronic immune deficiency, and hypogammaglobulinemia. Approximately 25 to 65% of patients have hypogammaglobulinemia at day 30. So we check IgG levels monthly and consider initiating IVIG for patients whose IgG levels drop below 400 milligrams per deciliter. CAR T therapy has shown to be very efficacious, with overall response rates ranging from 80 to 97%. clinical trials have shown deep and durable remissions. In summary, CAR-T is a novel approach to managing multiple myeloma, which is offering patients improved outcomes. Thank you so much for joining me today for discussion of CAR-T therapy in multiple myeloma. Please watch additional segments in this series.